Hi, guys. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Today is Sunday, January 23rd, 2022, and we have a live view from the Old Faithful web camera of Yellowstone. It's currently 3 degrees with the wind chill. I noticed one of the hot pools down there in the Firehole River was putting off a lot of dark steam. I think that's it right there. But anyways, there was 2 earthquakes in the last couple days that shook up the caldera there at Yellowstone. One came from Alaska. It was a magnitude 5.1. And another one that came from the Gulf of California. Both of those really shook up the caldera. Let me show you. You see them both in red here. We got one right there and one red right there that I'm going to cover first. This one came in at about 21:30 at Yellowstone. You can see the magma, the hot magma down there at the bottom. And we got gases that came up, hot water. It created harmonic tremors. Let me pull it over. That was a magnitude 5.2 in the Gulf of California on the 21st. 21:26 Universal Time. And that was Friday. It took about 4 minutes for the seismic wave to arrive there at Yellowstone and stir everything up. All right, this other one that came from Alaska, it stirred up Yellowstone too. That one showed up at about 5:24 Universal Time. So that took only about 6 minutes for its seismic wave to show up there at Yellowstone. Some of the reports on EMSC said no damage but troublesome. Another one said it was a good shake and then a jolt, but it was kind of different. It was like side to side instead of front to back. It was like a mishmash of both at the same times. One hard jolt out on oil platform. Yeah, a lot of people don't realize that depending on which direction the wave, the energy is forced. Yeah, sometimes they shake up Yellowstone and there's its location. Now for the newbies, new people who have recently joined us, I've talked about how it doesn't matter where you take the earthquake reading from. You need to get 3 different locations to triangulate where it occurred. But to get the magnitude, as long as you got the entire seismic signature, it doesn't matter. It will read the same thing. This earthquake, which registered there at Yellowstone, which actually occurred there in Alaska, came in as a 5.12. And you can see it down there at the bottom. So as I said, long as you got the entire seismic signature, when you're measuring an earthquake, it doesn't matter how far it is. As long as you got the entire signature, it will still show you the magnitude. On the weekends, USGS does not work. I don't know why. No one's there answering the text messages when they get alerts of an earthquake. We got one right here in red. And let's go over here. It's on both monitors. Came in at 10:12 Universal Time. It's got a small P wave on it. It's actually probably 2 earthquakes in 1. So I'll divide it up as 2. And the first one comes in as a magnitude 1.12. And the second one is at least 1.60, but it's probably a little bit bigger because the seismic signature actually trails on for a little bit. This one is not the earthquake that occurred there in the Gulf of Mexico, because that one occurred at 10:12 and 50 seconds. And this one occurred, probably about 10:12 and 25 seconds. The Gulf of Mexico one came in later. We have another one marked in red This one here is Maple Creek, and this is Moose Creek, Idaho. These two monitors are quite a ways from each other. At 16:02, almost 16:03 Universal Time, there's a spectrogram. This was a small earthquake. It comes in as a magnitude 1.59. That's that one right there, 1.59. Another earthquake marked in red that USGS is not reporting at about 10:12 Universal Time. It's closer to Maple Creek. It's got a shorter P wave. Remember my last report that I did about Yellowstone, I believe it was. P waves go directly through the Earth. That's why it's always the first signature. And then the S wave will not go through anything liquid like the core of the Earth. So that comes in second. Another way to think of the S wave is surface. It goes around the surface of the Earth. It's got farther to travel. This earthquake comes in as a magnitude 2.08. Looks like after the wave started settling down, there was probably a rush of magma that came into the system. So it opened up, that fault line opened up and let some more magma come in. That's what it looks like to me. All kinds of activity has been going on there at Maple Creek. You can see we got another one marked in red. That's actually two earthquakes. We got another one right there, 1925. Is it that one? Marked in red. 1958, we got another one, 1858. This here is what they classify as blobs of magma, hot magma coming up into the system. If you guys go to the thumbnails, you'll see here that Maple Creek's been really active. Using Google Earth, here's the location of Maple Creek. And then over here, we have Hedgin Lake. Earthquake Lake. Right there is the location of the monitor. Let me zoom in a little bit. All right, I'm going to show you the location for the Moose Creek, Idaho station and show you how far it is from the other one. It's about 40 miles. I marked it in yellow for you. So here's Hedgin Lake, Grayling Lake, Earthquake Lake. This here is Yellowstone Lake. And this here is Moose Creek, Idaho. So I wanted to explain that to show you why the earthquake was smaller at Moose Creek than it was there at Maple Creek. Going back to that earthquake at 10:12, this is Moose Creek, Idaho. This is Maple Creek. And we'll look at the two signatures. This is why it's got a longer P wave on it than it does here at Maple Creek. All right, 16:02. You can see it here at Maple Creek and Moose Creek. Moose Creek is just a little blip. Another very small earthquake. That comes in as a magnitude 1.58. We'll go to the spectrogram. This earthquake, again, is not being reported. They don't report on the weekends. This one here comes in as a magnitude 1.60. And there's so many of them, I could go through them all. You can see we got one there. These are just the ones in red. Just today alone. So that's all I have for you right now. If any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you very much for your support. Boy, you know who you are. Thank you. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. And always be prepared for some sort of disaster. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you all.